leads a lot of people to believe, for some reason, Sting's not with TNA anymore. So WWE puts out these really cryptic videos hyping up 2/21/11. And it's going to be this big debut. It actually turns out to be the return of The Undertaker. Okay. And for some reason, I have no idea how this started. The internet believed, for some reason, that Sting had signed with WWE and was going to face The Undertaker at WrestleMania. I have no idea how this rumor came about. I have no idea what foundation this rumor even had. But apparently, Sting was going to come and he was going to be facing The Undertaker at WrestleMania. Okay, whatever. Well, he wasn't. He was still under contract with TNA. And TNA decides to rub it in the internet's face one more time and puts out this video. Exact copy of the Undertaker hype videos, wasn't it? Right down to the font. Right down to the font. This thing is a complete ripoff. And what's even worse is that they didn't even film one new piece of footage for this fucking video. They used clips from Bound for Glory hype videos about Sting and the old TNA signatures and shit. Not one new piece of footage was shot for this. They didn't even try to make it look authentic. They didn't even try to make it look like, okay, we're gonna rip this off, let's do it right. No, they're gonna take footage from the old archives, put a blue sepia tone on it, and then rip off the font and say, hey, we put work into this. So, we get the hype video, and it turns out, on 3/3/11, Sting returns to TNA in a clown suit and beats Jeff Hardy for the world title.